What's going on, real ones? BCHQ back with another reaction. And with everything that's going on at the moment around the world with this coronavirus, I saw this drop in the thumbnails on the suggested videos. We got my guy Tom McDonald with coronavirus. Now, he's very smart putting a song out titled this at this point in time because he knows he's going to get eyes on it. And that's a smart marketing move and like self-promoting move. Very smart of Tom to do that. I can't wait to get into it, man, because his songs always address stuff that a lot of people don't want to talk about. So let's get into it. Got the mask on already. I don't know what to think about this virus. Started in China, now everybody in America's hiding. There's no groceries because people start to panic and buy it. The shelves are empty, the ones with plenty already stockpiling. Y'all making memes, think it's funny? Wait a week till the riots. Wait a month till the only way to eat is be violent. It's not the sickness, it's scary. Wait till a month and the only way to eat is be violent. And I do think it's going to come to a point where there's going to be like riots out on the roads. Because if they try and bring the army and shit in to try and stop people going out and doing shit, people ain't gonna like it. And I've done a video separately discussing this coronavirus in the last discussion episode. It's gonna get worse in terms of people arguing with each other, getting each other's throats and all that. So it's gonna be interesting to see how it plays out, because the government are gonna try and shut things down and potentially bring the army in to try and, basically, martial law is what it is. But I do think there's going to be riots and shit, because not everyone's going to want to just stay in their house now. Like, you're asking too much, even if you're trying to prevent a spread of something. I'm not buying all that shit anyway. But I'm just saying, it's definitely going to get worse before it gets better. It's all the people who whine and the government lying. They're trying to keep us calm through the sirens. You know it's for real. And all the pharmaceutical giants don't have a cure that they can sell you. So now everyone's dying. There's no vaccines or medication made that can fight it. I guess it's time to pray to God we can't rely on the science. And everyone around me in a mask and some gloves. The stock market crashed and the banks bought the bus. Tell us sanitizer. Everybody's around me with some masks and some gloves. And no word of a lie, I was walking down the street the other day. I saw a guy in his car with one of them masks on. In his car. It's spread through the air, so I understand why he's wearing it, but why wear it while you're in your car? And the he had the window shut and everything, so the paranoia is getting ridiculous. But that's why you need to stay away from the news and the media as much as you like. As much as people watch it, you're just torturing yourself. Crazy. This will pass. It's a bug. Stay inside. You'll be fine till we're trapped there for months. It's a ghost. Now we're in this together. This a pandemic. And also, what I want to go back to as well, at the beginning of the video, is on about stockpiling, people like buying out of stores. People are doing that in a blind panic, in a selfish reason as well. I know that we've got to, like, in case like it gets worse and we need food and that, but the shops, not all the shops are going to close. So, and people that are taking shit two or three items at a time for themselves, everyone should be rationed. And also, everyone's doing this, going in massive queues, coming into contact with each other in the shops, doing all this stockpiling, not realising they're probably part, whoever, if one person in that supermarket's got this virus, how quick is that going to spread in that supermarket, even while you're stockpiling? People's common sense is ridiculous. Listen to the news, because they lied to us for years, so how we know that this is the truth, and most of us are young enough. Why are you listening to the news? They lied for us for years. Why do you think they're going to tell you the truth? Come on. The pandemic, but we don't listen to the news because they lied to us for years. So how we know that this is the truth? And most of us are young enough to think that we're immune, so we just pass it on to people who won't survive it like you. It's either worse than they're telling us or it's nothing at all. But the school shut down, a ghost town in the mall. They go quarantine the city, block the road out of Dodge, then tell us leaving our homes is actually breaking the law. This is what I'm waiting for. Tell me not to leave my home. Watch me leave my home. You're gonna have to arrest me. I ain't be on house arrest. Are you mad? Doctors get sick, the hospitals won't work. The conspiracy theories all sound like facts, that's for sure. But the fact is, we're trapped on this planet called Earth. And the bleach gone, the bread gone, the water sold out. The meat gone, the milk gone, the pasta sold out. Cool. Don't leave anything for anyone, you hoard it for yourself. You'd rather tell them go to hell than be a man and go in hell. We're locking all our doors, now we're sticking together. We're hoping for the best,
but we're preparing for the worst. There's one thing we're not scared of, it's hard work. We're up against an enemy that doesn't have a face. There's no bombs we can drop, there's nowhere we can aim. There's no soldiers to stop with a tank at the gates. There's no cure that we've got or a pill we can take. There's no food, it's been bought. The truth is, we're afraid. We sit inside our rooms and we pray.
I think what we've got to remember that's important, that I think people need to take away from this at this moment in time. Don't be crippled and disabled about leaving your house. You still got to live your life. There's still people going to work at the moment, even though a lot of places are shut down now. Don't be crippled into fear of not even opening your front door or something like that. That's what they want. Don't do it. Be smart, be strong, be safe. Together we will overcome. Do your part, and that's facts. So that was Tom McDonald with coronavirus. As I said at the beginning, he's a very smart man to drop this at this point in time. He's going to get a lot of eyes on him because of the moment in time as well. Like, he can't have timed it any better, so... And he's talking some shit in here that people need to hear. So definitely a pass, definitely fire. Shout out to Tom McDonald once again, addressing stuff that not a lot of people are. So shout out to Tom. Definitely a pass. Shout out to everyone supporting. They don't want to fuck with the real ones.